welcome back. And if you tuned in late today, we're talking about, yes, butterflies and gardens and how you can attract butterflies. And they are a blessing in this area. We have many beautiful butterflies. And Donna Hopkins is here with me. She is a master gardener, and she has a love for butterflies, I guess,
yes,
you could
I
say.
Do.
And I thank you, Donna, for giving us your expertise. And so we found out about the little, I guess you could call it a little container just to hold a little water.
Yes, just enough.
And a
little
black
sand,
rock.
A dark rock. Or any dark object.
All right.
Yes,
okay.
That will absorb warmth.
Okay.
And we talked about the three of the top nectar plants.
And they're not hard to grow in this area.
No, they're not. And there are several other nectar plants that you can grow. And I mean, there's a lot. But kind of the basics, if somebody's just starting, there are others, and I'll just run those real quick.
All right.
All eight are lantana, zinnia, verbena, butterfly bush, milkweed, phlox, and sedum. Sedum is a little green, fleshy plant that I think, and it has a little flower, and I just think, who cares about that? That's not big and showy, but there's a butterfly that likes that nectar of that plant.
Okay.
So it makes a difference. The hardest part, haven't told you this part, the hardest part of butterfly gardening is to give the plants that the butterflies need to lay their eggs on. And the reason it's hard is because then the larvae hatch out of the egg, and little caterpillars, because that's what the larvae are, and they can eat a flat plant to nothing overnight. So it's hard, but they rarely kill that plant. Occasionally it will, but rarely do they do. Fennel is a host plant. I have had it, and it's beautiful, as tall as I am. I go out the next morning, and it's 2 inches tall. But in a week or two, it's just right back up there. But as a gardener, it is very difficult to offer up your plants. But if you don't, then your butterflies aren't going to come to your yard because they don't have those places to lay their eggs. Host plants of the upstate are very common. Some of them are clover, cabbage, passion flowers, liatris, fennel, and mistletoe.
Oh.
I didn't know when I was working for my kisses that I might could help butterfly too.
And so, all of these pesticides, I mean, that we all use, they harm not just butterflies, but even the birds.
They harm us. So it's only common sense that they harm every living thing. And even those little creatures we see that we don't like the way they look, and they might eat holes in our plants, but many of them are beneficial. And without them, our world would not be what they are. So it's kind of a balance, you know, especially if you're a gardener.
Let me ask you, Donna, do you use pesticides?
No, rarely.
How do you keep things the way they should be without pesticides?
I pull up the weeds.
Okay.
The only thing that we really use a pesticide on is poison oak, because I am very, very, very allergic. And so I stand on one end of the garden and I point. That's where I saw it. And my husband goes out and he sprays it.
Yeah.
Because no matter what you know, I live in the country, so especially. But that's the only thing that I use a pesticide on.
Okay. Now let me show people that this is the dearest little book. And it's Butterflies and Moths. And there's an 800 number you can call, and it says $5.95.
Yes.
And I wanted to show you this, and I'm going to open it up, and it's all the, look at this, the butterflies.
Now these over here, where the purple band is, these are moths, because this is about both. And so, you know, but they threw in the moths, which I think is a plus, because we don't think about those too much. And I don't know very much about moths.
Yeah. So this tells all different kinds, and some butterflies do well in this area, and other parts of the country.
Right.
So it depends on where you are.
Yes, it does.
But
about what you're going to
see. But if you had, now you don't have to have a big lavish garden.
Oh,
if you have just a few little plants, that would draw them, right?
Yes. If you have a deck, if you say in an apartment and you have a little deck the size of this area, and you had some containers with plants, you could incorporate the host plants and the nectar plants, and you could have a little puddling area. You could have a place for them to have received warmth.
And so they would still come.
So you could provide everything in this little space, and you could have your chair right here just to watch it all happening.
That would be wonderful. Are they endangered butterflies now?
I don't know of any specific, but I believe there are some endangered butterflies, but I'm sorry, I don't really know.
You know, there's
answer.
So much of this around,
yes,
and pesticides,
right,
and all that,
really,
that you wonder, because I know
right,
birds sometimes,
yes,
are affected by,
yes,
it.
Yes, they are.
And other
that's
a,
right,
as well.
Yes. So, and I feel certain that butterflies are not exempt from that.
Of course not.
So I'm sure that there may be some that are endangered.
Now, you obviously have attracted butterflies to your own,
yes,
surrounding by what,
yes,
you've learned.
Yes. I'm trying.
And
I'm still beginning. I'm still beginning.
But it isn't that difficult then.
No, it's not.
You just
no,
put
it isn't.
If you know the right plants to put out, then you just sit back and wait. Is
that's
that
right. And it's not a perfect science, but neither is it rocket science. But if you spend time in your garden, you can begin that you'll see. There's that little caterpillar, you know, sometimes, and you have to, they lay their eggs on the backs of the leaves, and so you have to hunt those. But if you pay attention in your garden, you can find them. A lovely place that you can really enjoy someone else's work, if someone doesn't have time at their own home, is at the Roper Mountain Science Center. They have a butterfly garden, which the master gardeners of Greenville County take care of.
Now, that would be a nice place to take your children.
It is marvelous because it is big enough that you can enjoy it, but it's not a day long. You could go for an hour, and your children would enjoy that amount of time.
So they actually have a butterfly garden.
Yes, they do. And on second Saturday, they have master gardeners in the garden, and they can tell you about the butterfly garden. They can tell you why the plants are there, which ones and why, who they attract. They know their butterfly garden so well that they know where all those little caterpillars are, and that, you know, and so it's a wonderful place,
okay,
and it's a resource right here in Greenville County.
All right, now you, for those people, so when a butterfly, they lay eggs.
Yes.
On the back of a leaf.
Yes.
Most of the
generally,
time. Generally.
Generally. Mm-hmm.
And then, how do they emerge?
Those little eggs hatch, and that's the larva, and they're commonly called caterpillar.
All right.
Their sole job is to eat. That's all they do. And sometimes they live for several weeks, months. Sometimes it's only a couple of days. They form a chrysalis, and sometimes they stay in over winter. Sometimes they're in that just a few days, depends. They're all very different. If you just hold the, let's see, I know it's somewhere in here. Right here, it shows some examples of chrysalis, and they're very different. Green, black, red.
And these become caterpillars.
And then, well, that does it. This is almost like an armor. It's like their protection while they're metamorphosing inside.
Okay.
And especially the lighter green ones, if you look very closely, you can see the wings of the butterfly inside. And when it's time, they break their way out, and then they just kind of hang there because they're very new and they're wet. But when they dry, then there's the butterfly.
And they're able to fly off.
Yes, they do.
That's amazing.
And it's so often that I'll see some little brown rolled up something laying on a plant, and I think, get off of there. And I realize after I do it that it was a chrysalis, and I just,
and then you just
did away with a butterfly.
Did away with some butterflies.
So I quit doing that. It may not be a chrysalis, but I'm not going to take a chance anymore.
If anybody's interested in this little butterfly and moth booklet, There is an 800 number that you can call, and I have it. It's 800-434-2555, and you can find out if it's about $5.95. I don't know if, you know, how interested people really are, but that's a delightful book.
I like it because it has basic information all in one little place.
And I'll always keep the information here that you can contact me if you didn't get it. But Donna, how long have you been a master gardener?
Since 2008.
And you have to, you become a master gardener, and then you have to agree to give 40 hours of your time back to the community.
To be certified. Now, if I just wanted to take the classes, which are available in the classroom at the
Clemson
Extension Office here in Greenville,
yeah,
or you can take it online. If I just want to do that, then I'm just, I took the class, but I'm not a master gardener. To be a master gardener and be certified, then you give 40 hours of community service,
volunteer hours. And it can be in many different ways.
And they're in many different ways.
Do you ever go into schools with a program like this? Because I think it would be fascinating for children.
The Greater Greenville Master Gardeners has a speakers bureau.
Okay.
And we have over 100 programs that we have presentations on. And we go into schools, we go into garden clubs, we go to nursing homes, all sorts of places to provide information, because that's the job of a master gardener, is to take this information into the community.
Well, I thank you for sharing your ability and your knowledge with us today. And most of us just see a butterfly flit by and we think, oh, isn't that pretty? And that's as far as it goes, but there's a lot to learn.
Yes,
and
there
it's
is.
Fascinating.
But you can keep it sized enough that it doesn't get too big.
Okay. Thank you so much for sharing,
Donna. I appreciate being
Hopkins,
here.
Hopkins, who has been our master gardener for today. And wherever you go, we just wish you happiness. And we'll see you next time.